process had came, he's taking her from vagina done. She really has to dilate every day, no shade. There's like 10 different dildos that they give you and you have to like put it inside and like make sure it opens. Because if not, bitch, it closes. Gag.
Like so, an ear.
It's, yeah, like a, yeah. It's like, the gift shops are very expensive, don't even do it. It's me, my sis. You know, doing what we do best. Shitting on you hoes. For free.
So, Lali, how do you feel?
My clothing is not working. In all honesty, I feel really anxious. I'm excited, but I'm also nervous. I just don't like pain. Like, pain is not for me, you know? I'm just nervous for the pain. But I'm excited. I got lots of.
Are you excited for the drugs?
Oh my god, bitch, Danny, oxycodone, Percocet, I'm ready. And you got my little cup, show them the cup.
I see the cup.
Look how cute it is. They about to come back. I have, listen, let me tell you guys something. It's been 24 hours since I had something to drink in my body. I am gagging. I need a sip of water. It should never hit this level. I'm very incognito. I just feel very meh.
Well, you look amazing going in, so.
Oh, thank you, and I'm gonna look amazing coming out. No shade. I just don't want anyone to question me on where I got my work done, because at the end of the day, it was for free. But it's gonna be the fabric. I feel like once I blow up on YouTube, NYU is gonna make me come back and do a whole campaign for them. But I'm here for it, because it's a check.
It's supposed to be for the kids, but okay.
It's not for her kids.
But yeah, I'm just really documenting because I really want everyone to experience this process, and also just so I can look back on my own process, you know? That's really what it is.
See how far along you came.
Yeah, like, you know, I mean, I already came far, but like just as my transition as like for like surgery wise, you know?
Yeah.
Because like, you know,
that's
knowing,
really amazing.
Knowing that I'm going to do my boobs, which what I'm doing now, but like, you know, doing that, but like this is the first surgery that's going to process to many other things. Like, I'm gonna do my face, then I'm gonna do my body. There's just so many other things that I'm gonna get into, and this is like the number one. It's the start of it all. So I'm excited, and I'm happy that you guys could join this journey with me. Subscribe to my channel now. Like, comment, whatever you guys would want to say or think, whatever. Feel free. Follow me on all my social medias. Instagram, The Porcelain Doll. Snapchat, The Porcelain. Twitter, The Porcelain. Cut the cameras. Nah, for real, just sound really thirsty. They said they're gonna have me here for like an hour. All my niggas is hitting me up right now. I don't know. I'm fully naked under here. I only have my thong on. That's about it. They gave me these hot ass blankets. I'm mad hot right now. Give a round of applause to my hoes. My sis, my other sis behind the camera carrying for me. Really giving me what I need for my life, for y'all lives. They made me take my belly ring out. It better not close, bitch. I'm too tired.
I knew that they would have. I told you, they don't play that.
I'm so over it. I already have these glasses on because I look like shit. And y'all know that I look like shit. No shade. I took mad pictures in the bathroom with the gown on. Okay, so seriously, I don't know if I should post the picture of the bear and me or the picture of like me in the hospital like that.
The bear and you.
The bear and like, you.
No, not the bear and me like this right now.
I know, we know what picture you're talking about.
Yeah, but how? Like, what should my caption be?
Wish me luck.
Mm. Going into surgery.
Something regular.
Like what? Like
that's that. As simple as that.
They're gonna be like, "Bitch, you're posting a picture."
You started off so simple as that because right after, it's to carry.
Or should I post this? Or should I post that?
No.
No.
No, that's not it.
That's not it. I know it's not it.
Like, excuse me, I just came here because my stomach virus. Like,
yeah.
You gotta get something else. Like, I'm doing
something. Yeah, just do something clear. Like,
I'm doing this, y'all.
Yeah.
I'm doing that. Follow me on my Instagram. The Porcelain.
Okay. I'll put the date for you.
I should have itch, bitch. It's totally fine.
Well, I'll take it. The glasses.
You gotta take the Celine's off.
Oh. Yeah, we can work on it. Is that okay? I know it's not comfortable, but is it uncomfortable? It's alright? Alright, we'll be back in 15 minutes.
Thank you.
Okay, she left. Now it's all take turns.
Right. What does it smell like?
What does it smell like?
That's my shit. Because I'm fucking hungry. I smell her.
You smell like
rag. It smells good. It smells like lavender.
Let's all get a smell.
That new smell nice. That new smell nice. If you're at ease and gone, bitch, you're not gonna get the hard stuff. I need you to get the hard shit.
I've messed with each other plate. So I'm gonna say I don't feel no.
Baby, that didn't work. Give me something.
Baby, I need something stronger.
Okay, that's right. Okay. Maybe I need some
this pepper. I know.
Go, what the fuck?
That's the sauce.
Yes, I'm starving and very dehydrated. Do you know how long it's gonna take until we start, like until the surgery starts?
Oh,
probably
like 10 minutes or something. Yeah, that's
what
I'm
saying. Oh, wow.
Like one last step. Yeah. We literally just got out. They're just cleaning up the room now.
I need that.
Yeah, you need that, right?
Yeah, I need that.
Okay. Let's see. Here is the consent form. It's the general anesthesia. That's what I mentioned.
Okay.
This is like the medical legal, cover all your bases type of thing. But the stuff that I talked about with you is, most pertinent to you. If you want to read through it, you can. Otherwise, you just sign just underneath this.
Okay, I'm just going to sign.
Okay.
So, I know I look crazy, but I'm about to go into surgery. They already marked all my breasts up. I'm not going to show so much, but... we marked everything up. I'm excited. It's about to be something.
How do you feel?
I feel fucked up. Bitch, I'm on. Ooh. I feel it. My titties hurt so much. They're so like high right now. Well, I'm gonna show you over the days, the process of it. To everyone watching this, I hope you learned something from it. The lesson was, no matter what, you always be a bad bitch. Never stop believing in yourself, bitch, you'll make it. It's been 3 years in the works for me getting this shit done, and they're just titties. But it's alright, because I'm about to get my face done next month. So that's going to be cute. And I'm going to do my teeth, so she should be fine. Subscribe, like, and comment. Follow me on Instagram, The Porcelain Doll. Follow me on Twitter, The Porcelain. And also follow me on Snapchat, The Porcelain. So this is how they look for now. They feel really firm, but it's okay because they're gonna drop over time. Shout out to Dr. Rachel Buban-Langer. She's a very sweet person. She took very care of me. All the doctors here took such great care of me. I was trying to push to stay for tonight because I just wanted to make sure, I felt really stable, but it's totally fine. I feel like it's okay. I can go home.
Come on.
Oh, this is where the medicine is. Lifestyle isn't for everyone. Anyways, now that that embarrassing part is over, this is it. This is what they are. My scars are under. I'm gonna try to show you my scars now. So now that I'm a little closer, I'm gonna just pull this up a tiny tad bit. I don't know if you guys can see, but that's how they are. It's nothing big. They're very faint. And this is the other side. They're very little. They look big on camera, but they're really not. They're very tiny. Also, they're still healing, so they look a little reddish, I guess. I am very fair, so it will look more redder than usual. I'm gonna get some bleaching cream to make them fade a little faster. And this boob, I have 700 cc's. And then this boob, I have 750, because this boob was bigger than this one. So she put 750 on this side and 700 on this side. But literally, since my boob was already something, in total, it's like I have like 800 cc's or around there. So let's start from the beginning. I went in early in the morning. They did blood work. They put me the IV or whatever. I was sitting there maybe for an hour or two before I seen Dr. Bubon. She came in, marked up my breast, marked here, all through here, under here, the side, everything. I waited maybe like 5 minutes. Me going into the room, it was literally the scariest thing ever. The surgeons were in the room, the lights were on, the scalpels, things on the table. It was so scary. What ran through my head was like, oh my god, is this really what I want? I'm really about to go through with this. 2 seconds, I'm like, no, this is really what you want. This is it. This is the next step in your transition. Like, this is everything for you. I lay down on the table. They put the anesthesia in me. I felt like a little burning running up my arm. They were like, you're about to fall asleep in like maybe like a minute or two. I'm like, wait, what? Like, does it work that fast? As soon as I asked that question, she looked at me in the face and she was like, I'm looking up at her like, is it working? After I said, is it working? I fell out. I remember anything, nothing. I woke up, literally all I remember was like pain. My opinion, I felt like someone was sitting on my chest. And they were so like, they were up here. Obviously, when you come out of the surgery, it's gonna be swollen. But like, I'm over here fucking fresh off anesthesia, still on anesthesia, mind you. Like, it was literally like, it was crazy. Like, the pain was insane to me. They ended up giving me some perks or whatever, so it was pretty good. My cousin and my best friend was outside the room waiting for me. Literally, as soon as they walked in the room, I started dying laughing. I don't remember what it was, but they just made me fucking laugh so hard. Mom was like, when you guys go in there, don't make her laugh. She's in pain. Bitch, they walked in, I started dying laughing. He was like, bitch, we've been waiting out there for like 4 hours. Like, the surgery was done like 2 hours ago, but each time we fell asleep for like an hour or so. It literally felt like seconds. So the time came for me to walk. The nurse came in and she was like, okay, like, you know, you have to get up. You have to start walking a little bit. I walked a little bit. I used the bathroom. Then the time came for me to get ready. In the cab on my way home, the fucking cab driver was flirting with me so much. And I looked fucking a mess. He was asking me shit about my boobs and shit. And I'm over here looking at this guy like, can you shut up? Like, can you just please just drive me home, sir? I was so over it, literally so over it. He was being nice though, because he was trying not to hit any bump, because I told him I just got my boobs done. But he was still flirting with me. But he was from the Bronx, so maybe I gotta go. No, that's not for me. But yeah, it's been a few weeks and here we are. But the reason why I'm wearing this top today is one, to show you, and two, so you can see the before and then now the after. My next surgery is my face surgery. I'm gonna be doing my face, my FFS. So please stay tuned in the description below. Follow my Instagram, add me on Snapchat, follow my Twitter. I'm very social, so I always like reply back, I comment back. But yeah, definitely follow me on Instagram because I'm very active on there, and you can just swipe up and, you know, send me any questions for my next Q&A. If you guys are curious about anything, don't be afraid to ask, just ask away. But definitely, so subscribe to my channel and hit the bell for post notifications. But until next time, guys, stay plastic.